Hi. Now, before anything else, I'd just like to say that if you haven't watched the videos for the first part of this chapter, then please do so before watching this one. Okay? Because there are topics that we needed from that discussion or from those videos that we're gonna use in this part of the chapter. Okay? But if you did watch it already, then let's start with gases. Now, in this part of the chapter on gases, we will talk about the three simple gas laws. In addition to that, we're going to talk about Avogadro's law as well, ideal gas law, and how we could use ideal gas law to calculate some quantities that are related to gases, like the molar mass of a gas and the density of a gas. Further on in this discussion, we'll also talk about reaction stoichiometry involving gases. So, how can we use quantities like pressure, volume, and temperature of a gaseous compound, either a reactant or a product in the reaction, so we could calculate for quantities like mass or moles of other compounds involved in the same reaction? And then, lastly, we'll talk about diffusion and how it's different from effusion. We'll also relate the molar mass of gaseous compounds to the speed with which it can effuse. So that's what we're going to talk about in this discussion. Now, I tried to record this a few days ago, but it went up to 2 hours and 30 minutes, I think. So if it does get a bit long, I'll probably cut the video into two. Okay. So that's that. Let's start with Boyle's law. Now, Boyle's law is the first of three simple gas laws. These gas laws express the effect of one variable on another with the remaining two variables held constant. Now, what variables am I talking about? I'm talking about the factors that can affect the behavior of a gas, like pressure, volume, number of moles, and temperature. Now, again, let me repeat that. The three gas laws express the effect of one variable on another with the remaining two variables held constant. For Boyle's law, the number of moles and temperature is held constant, right? At constant temperature, the volume occupied by a fixed amount of gas is inversely proportional to the applied external pressure. So, itong dalawa yung constant natin for Boyle's law. And then, volume can change, and then it will have an effect on pressure, or vice versa. Pressure yung nag-change, it will have an effect on the volume. Now, what effect is that? It's inversely proportional. That means, let's look at the illustration. That means that if your pressure decreases, tumiit yung pressure doon sa takip ng container, movable na takip ng container, then the volume increases. Why? If the pressure that pushes down on the movable na takip ng container is less than the pressure that the gases exert on all sides of the container, then if konti lang, let's represent that by a smaller arrow. If konti lang yung pressure, mas malaki yung pressure dito, pushing upwards, then of course, the stronger pressure will prevail. So, mapupush niya yung takip na container upwards, thus increasing the volume. The opposite happens if you increase the pressure. Now, malakas na yung pressure that pushes it downwards. That means makokompress yung gases. If the pressure, external pressure ha, if the pressure exerted on the takip is greater than the pressure exerted by the gas inside the container, then it will be compressed. Because if you remember from the part one of this chapter, gas is highly compressible. So if there is a difference in pressure between the outside and the inside, then it will probably be compressed. Now, mathematically, we could express Boyle's law into this. This is the mathematical representation of Boyle's law. Now, as I've said earlier, n, or the number of moles, is constant, t is also constant, and then r is forevermore constant. That's the universal gas constant. So that has a constant numerical value. Now, what we need is to have the constants on one side of the equation and the non-constants or the variables on the other side of the equation. So to do that, we'll just wait. There we go. So we will just multiply both sides by V. So multiply yan by V. Mag-crush out yung 1 over V sa kabila. And now you've got PV is equal to nRT, or just PV is equal to constant. Right? Now let's look at this animation right here. Now it increases the pressure by putting additional weight on top of the movable na takip. If you can see here, as the pressure increases, napupush down niya yung takip, lumiliit yung volume ng container. Right? Yung mass or yung number of moles ng gases, hindi nag-change, walang mass, walang gases na nag-travel from that area into the container or outwards into this syringe thing. Now, if we express that graphically, and it will look like this. Frozen yung mass, as well as the number of moles, and also the temperature. We have volume on the y-axis, pressure on the x-axis, and we can see now that nagde-decrease yung volume, nag-i-increase yung pressure. So that's how the graph looks like if you have inversely proportional na mga quantities. What about Charles' law? Now, Charles' law is Charles' law expresses the relationship between volume and temperature of a gas. Now, there's a bit of a debate kasi whether we should call it Charles' law or Charles and Gay-Lussac's law, because this is the product of the work of scientists Jacques Charles and Joseph Louis Gay-Lussac. They're both French scientists who was working on this topic a century after Boyle. So their experiment showed that at constant pressure, the volume occupied by a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to its absolute Kelvin temperature. Again, we're talking about Kelvin here because Kelvin is the SI unit of temperature. So sinabi ko kanina, directly proportional. At constant pressure, tingnan niyo yung illustration natin, hindi nag-change yung pressure. Yung nag-change lang is temperature and volume. Again, the number of moles will be assumed constant. So, na-lower yung temperature, na-compress yung gas. Lumiit yung volume, di ba? Pag na-compress, liliit yung volume. And then, higher the temperature, volume increases. Yan yung nangyayari sa hot air balloons natin. Because when you heat a gas, the gas usually expands. There are, of course, there are some very rare exceptions, but as a rule of thumb, if you heat up a gas, it will expand. And if the container is flexible or elastic or movable, then it will also increase the volume of a gas. Of the container that is containing the gas. Yan yung nangyayari sa hot air balloon. Again, hiniheat niya yung gas inside the balloon. Di ba may stove, parang open flame na stove. Tapos if the flame is there, the gases inside the balloon heats up. and then it will exert pressure on the sides, all the sides of the balloon. It will cause the balloon to expand, and since hot air rises, since it's less dense than cold air, so it rises, and then you rise with it. That's how blimps and hot air balloons work. So mathematically, we could express Charles' law like this one. Again, in this case, pressure is constant as well as the number of moles, and R again is constant. So we make sure that all constants are one side and variables on the other. So we multiply both sides by 1 over t. Now we have V over t is equal to constant. In this animation, makikita natin hindi nag-change yung weights. So para yun, hindi daw mag-change yung pressure. Hindi din nag-change yung mass because no gas is passing through this small area here. Nakikita lang natin is the increase in or decrease of temperature accompanied by an increase of volume or decrease of volume. Now, graphically, makikita natin very linear yung change. Increasing volume also is accompanied by an increasing temperature. So if you heat up the gas, the volume increases. And then if you do the opposite, then the opposite occurs. If you lower the temperature, then the volume decreases. Now let's look at Amundsen's law. Now Amundsen's law is sometimes called Gay-Lussac's law, but after a few years, I think after much debate and looking at history, it was determined that Amundsen, I think Amundsen's yung name niya. So dapat nandito yung apostrophe. So Amundsen first put together this concept. However, he had only access to air as a gas, whereas Gay-Lussac had access to oxygen gas, to nitrogen gas. That's why siguro his name had more weight at the time, but we should be calling this Amundsen's law and not Gay-Lussac's law. And by the way, yung Charles' law, again, Charles' law is sometimes called Charles and Gay-Lussac's law. For more details, you can look up Gay-Lussac's law on Wikipedia. Anyway, Amundsen's law is derived from Charles and Boyle's law. It expresses a relationship for the effect of temperature on pressure. So if we increase temperature or decrease temperature, what's its effect on pressure? So here, di ba, pressure and temperature lang. So we have number of moles is constant and volume is constant because at constant volume, the pressure exerted by a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. Here we can see hindi nag-change yung volume ha. Again, it's constant. And then if you increase the temperature, the pressure increases as well. And then if you do the opposite, you lower the temperature, liliit yung pressure. Ganito yung nangyayari with a pressure cooker. Specifically, when it comes to pressure cooking, it can allow the chef or I don't know, my mom to cook food at a very high temperature in a shorter amount of time, or it allows us to reach temperatures na hindi kaya ma-reach ng stove at saka kaldero lang. Because some things like tenderizing beef or performing pressure canning, like making your own canned goods, it requires high temperature and high pressure. So that's one way to accomplish it with a pressure canner or a pressure cooker. Now, for here, tingnan natin, di ba, nakalagay pa Charles Law. Sometimes it's still called Charles Law because Amundsen's, yung pag-refer natin ng Amundsen's Law, sometimes hindi ginagamit ng books. But again, that's Let's give credit to where credit is due and kailangan siyang amontons law. Okay? So for mathematical na equation, N is constant, R, of course, is constant, volume is constant, so kailangan natin itawid si T on the other side, and then we do that by multiplying both sides by 1 over T. Now, finally, we have P over T is equal to constant. Now, we have this in animation right here. Hindi nag-change yung number of moles of gases. Hindi nag-change yung volume. Yung nag-change lang is yung pressure and temperature. They are directly proportional. That means you increase the temperature, you also expect an increase of pressure. And then if you go the other way, you decrease the temperature, you will also have a decreased pressure. Now let's put together all the other graphs that we've seen so far. Now for Boyle's law, let's review. Boyle's law, inversely proportional, yung pressure and volume. So you decrease the volume, you can increase the pressure. You increase the pressure, you decrease the volume. So baliktad sila. Sa Charles and Gay-Lussac's law, the Charles and Gay-Lussac's law, it's directly proportional in volume and temperature. If you increase the temperature, you can have an increase in volume. And then here we have the Amontons law. Increasing the temperature leads to an increase of pressure. Now, so far, yung tatlong gas laws na discuss natin, all have a fixed amount of gas, diba? Palaging yung N is constant. Now, what happens if other variables are fixed? And then yung amount of gas, much a change. So let's look at this illustration here. So here we have our setup A and our setup B. The setup A natin, meron tayong, this is a solid carbon dioxide. That's dry ice. And then that's 0.1 moles of dry ice. And then when it gets warmer, your dry ice sublimates. So it will not become a liquid, but rather it will become a gas. So solid to gas. That's sublimation. So once it becomes a gas, it completely becomes a gas. Meron na tayong gas pressure, right? Kasi kanina walang gas, so walang pressure from the gas inside. Then once it turns into a gas, it starts to exert pressure on all sides of the container. And then this part is movable, so it can start pushing against it. Now, it results into a volume, a certain volume. Now, on setup B, we have double the amount of dry ice. We have double the amount of moles. So 0.1 sa setup A, 0.2 sa setup B. Now, when it sublimated, once nag-sublime yung gas, it also resulted to double the volume. Kanina, ito lang. Now we have this right here. It's double the volume from double the amount of gas. So at constant temperature, when all the solid has changed to gas, the setup B has twice the volume of the one on the left. So this behavior is expressed in Avogadro's law. Now, ano yung mga fixed natin na mga variables? Mga fixed natin na mga quantities at fixed temperature and pressure, the volume occupied by a gas is directly proportional to the amount or moles of gas. So that is, kung mag-increase yung number of moles natin, mag-increase din yung volume and vice versa. Equal volumes of any ideal gas contains equal numbers or moles of particles. We will see this later on. Now, ito yung kanina. Ito yung sa animation natin, di ba, hindi talaga nag-change yung mass or the number of moles. Ngayon, if we start here sa center and then we remove the gas, so we suck out some of the gas, nag-remove din ang gas, the volume decreases. Right? Tulad if hihigupin nyo yung air na nasa loob ng balloon, di ba, magde-decrease yung volume. And then if iihipan nyo yung balloon, that's you inject gas into the container, lalaki yung volume, right? Right? So at constant temperature and pressure, if you increase the number of gas, you also increase the volume. Now for Avogadro's law, we have V over N is equal to constant. Now let's revisit this statement here. At fixed temperature and pressure, equal volumes of any ideal gas contain equal numbers of, sorry, that's of moles of particles. Now that is a statement of Avogadro's law, restatement of Avogadro's law that's related to the gas behavior at standard conditions. So chemists have assigned a set of standard conditions, tinatawag nating STP. That's standard temperature and pressure. Our standard temperature is 0 degrees Celsius or 273.15 Kelvin. And then standard pressure is 1 atm equivalent to 760 torr. Now under these conditions, yung 1 mole of ideal gas natin, yung volume na equivalent of 1 mole of an ideal gas, yung tinatawag natin standard molar volume. So that's volume of 1 mole of ideal gas. It's this volume right here. That's 22.4141, or just 22.41, 22.4 liters. Now that goes for any gas as long as we can assume that it's ideal. So helium, nitrogen, oxygen, at standard temperature and pressure, 1 mole of these gases always have these volume. But tingnan natin, for 1 mole, 1 mole silang lahat, you will have the same pressure and temperature kasi nga standard, you will have the same volume. And since they're all 1 mole of different gases, they will have the same number of gas particles. Now, magde-differ lang sila in number one, yung mass, kasi magkaiba yung weights ng mga atoms ng gases nila, di ba? And then, because magkaiba yung masses, magkaiba din yung density. Kahit pareho yung volume nila, magkaiba yung mass nila, di ba? So the resulting density would be different. Now let's go to ideal gas law. By combining the individual effects ng mga gas laws natin na na-discuss kanina, we can now have the ideal gas law, sometimes called ideal gas equation. Kanina, di ba, fixed N and fixed temperature, you will have Boyle's law. That's PV equals constant. Now, at fixed number of moles and fixed pressure, you can have V over T is equal to constant. That's your Charles and Gay Lussac's law. And then you can also have P over T is equal to constant. That's your Amundsen's law. And your Avogadro's law is V over N is equal to constant at fixed pressure and temperature. Now, basahin natin yung red na font below. Caution, it says, R has a different numerical value when different units are used. So R is a constant known as universal constant. It will have different values depende kung anong units yung ginamit mo sa pag-calculate sa kanya. Anyway, Ideal Gaslaw describes the relationship. Pinagsama na diba yung Boyle's, yung Charles, yung Montons, and yung Avogadro's law. Now, what's an ideal gas? It's a hypothetical gas whose pressure, volume, and temperature behavior can be completely accounted for by the ideal gas equation. Of course, the world is rarely ideal, but we cannot account for every single difference in the gases of mga calculations natin, or else we will have very little na matapos na mga researches. So what we usually do is to approximate or to assume that at this condition, this gas is an ideal gas, behaves like an ideal gas. So it is assumed that the molecules of an ideal gas do not attract or repel one another, and their volume is negligible compared to the volume of the container. So ito yung pinaka-usual na approximation natin. So again, there's no such thing in nature as an ideal gas, but we just assume that at certain conditions, gases behave like an ideal gas. So again, for R, or the universal gas constant, at STP, meaning at 0 degrees Celsius, or 273.15 Kelvin and 1 atm, R has a value of 0.0821. That's 0.0821. Actually, that's 0.08206, but we can just shorten it to this one. It wouldn't make much of a difference kasi masyadong maliit na decimal. But that's fine. You can use 0.0821 or 0.08206. The unit is what's most important. This value, itong dalawang to, this would only work if your set of units is atm liter over mole k, or liter atm over k mole. That doesn't affect things. Because here, R has different units. So mag-iiba yung value. Here we have 8.314 joules per k, joules over Kelvin mole. It will have a different unit. Yung si ginagamit natin, this is, di ba? To the negative 2, that's 0.08. 20578. That's just the same as what I've told you kanina. 206, right? Or 0.0821. Those are the same things. It will only work for this set of units. And then different din kung bar, liter, different din kung Pascal, meter cube, iba din sa torr, liter, and iba din sa calorie per k mole. Okay, so be careful about that. So if you see, and ito na lang yung rule natin, no? If you see non-SI units, para magamit natin yung usual natin na universal gas constant, then convert that non-SI unit into SI units. Okay? Now let's look at a few examples. Here, number one. A 3.50 liter sample of neon gas has a pressure of 924 torr. What pressure in atm is required to compress the gas into a tank with a volume of 1350 centimeter cube at constant temperature? Tingnan natin ulit. Constant temperature, hindi na change yung number of moles of gases. So ano yung may constant na N and T? Tingnan natin. Now, I don't really memorize yung mga equation ng Boyle's, Charles and Gay-Lussac's, and Amontons' law, even Avogadro's law. What I do is that I look here. P is equal to nRT. Now, ano yung mga constant natin? We put it on one side and then the non-constant on the other. It's already here. That's a constant, that's a constant, that's a constant. That means if you have situation 1 equals this right here. And then you're given situation two, since hindi naman na-change yung mga constant, kasi nga, constant, it will have the same value, right? So, pwede nang maging P1, V1, is equal to P2, V2. Now, we're just gonna list down what we are given. So, we have volume 1, 3.50 liters, and pressure 1 of 924 torr. And then, you have volume 2, which is 1350 centimeter cubed, and you don't have pressure 2. So we're being asked for the pressure in atm. So that's in atm. Now let's play with the equation to get to solve for pressure 2. That's p1 v1 all over v2. Then we have non-SI units here, so we could either separately convert that into SI units, or we could just put that into one big calculation. So I can do that. But if parang nag-hesitate ka, then that's fine. Pwede mo din siya step by step. So P1 is 924 torr. We need to convert that into ATF. Conversion is 760 torr for every 1 atm times volume 1 is 3.50 liters, and then volume 2 is 1350 centimeter cube. We transform that, or we convert that into liters, so that's 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 ml, and then 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. Now, I put that into a calculator and you should get, let's see here. Please excuse the ads on this calculator. I am penniless and cannot afford to pay for a calculator app. So that's 1350 divided by 1000. That's 3.50. ATM. There we go. Now let's look if it's the same. It's not the same. 3.16 yung answer. Why? Because nag-round off na tayo dito. Now see? So there's a difference if you rounded off sa final answer na, or if nag-round off ka sa mga intermediate or sa mga in-between na steps. But that's this level of discrepancy, 3.16 versus 3.15, that's acceptable, that's fine. But if it's large discrepancies, then I think you should just round off doon na sa final answer. So these are the steps that I always follow. Summarize what's given, kung ano yung ask then, and then it's better if you put in kung ano yung units na hinahanap. Ganun. And you also put in kung ano yung variables, ano yung mga quantities na naka-constant. Then if you are hesitant to put it into one large calculation sa calculator, then you can convert first before you rearrange the ideal gas law, and then plugging in the values that you've calculated in step. But if you're a bit confident na, well practiced na yung calculator using skills, then go ahead. So this is why we should be familiar with the functions of our calculator, because it will help us to be very efficient. Now, number two, a balloon is filled with 1.95 liters of air at 25 degrees Celsius and then placed in a car and sitting in the sun. What is the volume of the balloon when the temperature in the car reaches 90 degrees Celsius? So, ano yung binigay sa atin? We have volume of 1.95 liters, temperature at 25 degrees Celsius, and then another volume, hinihingi sa atin, what is the volume of the balloon when the temperature, another temperature, reaches 90 degrees Celsius? So, yung mga constant natin is N and P. So N and P. Ano yung gagawin natin? That's PV is equal to NRT. Isolate natin yung N, R, tsaka P kasi constant sila. So V over T is equal to N, R over P. And then equal siya sa another setup ng V tsaka So V1 is equal over T1 is equal to V2 over T2. Ganun lang ginagawa ko. Okay? Since we're looking for volume 2, let's just rearrange it. V1 times T2 over T1. Then, volume is 1.95 liters times T2 is 90 degrees Celsius plus 273.15 Kelvin. 0.15 syllabus yung Kelvin dapat. And volume 2 is 15, 25 plus 273.15 Kelvin. That gives us 1.85 times 90 plus 273.15 all over 25 plus 273.15. That's 2.375. If we follow the correct number of significant figures, we will have 2.4, around 2.4 Kelvin. Ah, no, 2.4 liters. I'm sorry. So let's look if we have the same answer. See, it's 2.38, and then if you put that into two significant figures, that's 2.4. So we have the same answers. Let's go to number three. A scale model of a blimp rises when it is filled with helium to a volume of 55 decimeter cube. Now, when a 1.1 mole of helium is added to the blimp, the volume is 26.2 decimeter cube. How many more grams of HE or helium must be added to make it rise? Assume constant E and P. Constant yung T and P. So, P, PV is equal to NRT. Isolate natin yung temperature and pressure. Tsaka yung R. So, magiging V over N. RT is equal to P. V over N is your Avogadro's law, di ba? Volume and the number of moles. So we have situation one equal to situation number two. So ano yung given sa atin? V1 is 55.0 decimeter cube and 1.10 moles of helium. And then V1, V2 is 26.2 decimeter cube and N2 is missing. However, let's look at the question here. Yung required sa atin is how many more grams HE must be added? Hindi yung total amount of HE at the end. Ha? So, ilan yung dinagdag para mag-float siya? Okay, so let's try to solve for N2. N2 is equal to V2 over V1 times N1. Volume 2 is 26.2 decimeter cube. Times 1.10. Tingnan natin ha. Try natin to. And then V1 is 55.0 decimeter cube. Let's try to see if the answer makes sense. Does it make sense? What did we do wrong? Now, other people may say na yung decimeter cube ma'am, but 1 decimeter cube is equal to 1 liter. So basically, nothing will happen. Mag-iiba lang yung unit niya dyan. Right? Let's look at the problem again. Now, let's look at the problem again, ha? This is the situation na nag-rise na yung blimp. Ito yung volume niya. Before nag-rise yung blimp, ito yung volume niya. So, yung mali natin is nag-switch itong dalawa. Therefore, what we're looking for is not volume. What we're looking for is not yung kapartner ng 26.2. But rather, 26.2 and 1.10, sila yung magka-partner, and then 55.0, yan yung hinahanap natin na ka-partner niya. Okay? So, what did we learn at this part? It's very important to know kung saan yung kapares. So, P1, saan yung kapares niya na V1? Yung V1, saan yung kapares niya na N1, di ba? And saan yung kapares ng V2? So, saan yung N2? So, make sure that you read and you double read your question. Kaya useful yung part na ililist down mo kung ano yung binigay sa'yo. Okay? So, let's carry on. N2 is equal to V2 times N1 over V1. So, that's 55. Liters, kasi again, 1 decimeter cube is equal to 1 liter. So 55.0 liters times 1.1 mole all over 26.2 liters. 26.2 liters, that would give you 55 times 1.1 divided by 26.2. That's 2.14. Sakto ba? Ay, mali, mali. 55 times plus yung nilagay kanina divided by 26.2. So, it should be 2.309 moles of helium. Now, let's go back to what is required. How many more grams of helium must be added to make it rise? So, what we're looking for is the difference between these two converted to grams. Kasi tinatanong, must be added. So, ilan yung, how much yung inadd dito sa 1.1 moles. So, let's take the difference. So, let's put moles A for added. So, that's 2.309 minus 1.10 moles. That would give you minus 1.1. Oops, that gives you 1.2. 1.209 moles HT. And then we convert this into grams HE kasi ito yun yung hinahanap. Now grams HE, 1.209 moles of HE. Paano natin i-convert into grams? Now recall your chapter on stoichiometry. That's 1 mole HE is equal to the molar mass, so molar weight. So that's 4.003 grams of HE. Brush out the moles, we're left with grams. So that we have 4.003. Now we've got 4.84. Nawa ko ng 3 significant figures kasi 3 significant figures silang lahat. So that's the final answer. Is it correct? Let's look at the next page. So it is correct. 4.84 grams of helium. Now, pansin niyo yung ginawa ko. Although naglagay ako ng mga answers sa mga intermediate steps, hindi ko sila ni-round off. Instead, what I did was, diba, 3 significant figures yung final answer dapat. So nilagyan ko ng isang extra digit. Same here. Lagyan ko ng isang extra digit. Okay? That's a nicer way to put your solutions rather than this one. Kasi yan may rounding off error na yan siya. Okay? So it's just a good practice. It will not make a very big difference, but it's a significant, nice practice when you do it on your own. Okay, let's go to the next problem. A steel tank has a volume of 438 liters and is filled with 0.885 kilograms of oxygen gas. Now, what we're being asked to do is to calculate the pressure of the oxygen gas at 21 degrees Celsius. Tingnan natin ha. Anong binigay sa atin? Volume is equal to 438 liters. Mass, binigyan tayo ng 0.08, 0.885. 0.885 kilograms of O2. Binigyan din tayo ng temperature at 21 degrees Celsius. Pinapahanap sa atin is pressure. Wala tayong second na situation. So we will not have V1, V2, or T1, T2. Now, what law do we use in that in those situations? Walang constant, right? So we still just use the ideal gas law, and since wala nang constant, we just directly solve for what is being asked. So P is equal to nRT over V, right? So now just make sure that we have all non-SI units converted into SI units. Now we can do it into one in one big equation. So kunin natin yung number of moles from this one. So that's 0.885 kilograms times 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams of O2. And then 32.00 grams of O2 is equal to 1 mole of O2. So now we have our N. And then let's put in 0.0821 liter ATM all over mole K. So that's our R. And then for our T, we'll have 21 degrees Celsius plus 273.15 Kelvin. So now we have our T. And then lastly, we'll just have it 438 liters, right? So let's make one big fraction and then another small fraction inside a pair of parentheses. That's 0.885 times 1000 all over 32. Oops. Over 32. Now, in calculators, parentheses are your best friends. So make sure that you're using the right way to put in your parentheses. That's 21 plus 273.15 all over 438. So now you've got 1.52486, or just 1.5. Because this is two significant figures, three significant figures. So we follow two significant figures. Now we've got ATM. To make sure that we've got ATM, crush out, crush out, crush out. Kelvin, Kelvin, liters, liters, moles, moles, ATM na lang natira. Hindi nyo na dapat i-mind yung degree Celsius kasi kinonvert nyo na yan ng Kelvin, ha? Kinonvert na yan ng Kelvin. Okay, now let's look and see doon sa next page. It's 1.53. So maliit lang yung difference. And then don't mind this small error here. Kasi pareho lang naman yung solution natin. Yung ginawa lang is nag-step by step lang tayo. Tsaka pre-nug-in. Kaya may difference, may discrepancy tayo kasi nagka-rounding off error nga. Okay? But again, it's a small discrepancy. Doon tayo mag, let's choose our battles and let's, doon tayo mag-matter doon sa medyo mas malaking discrepancy. I think I'm gonna stop at this part and then resume in the next videos with the applications on ideal gas law. So I'll see you there. Goodbye for now.